Hello, I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, I'm going to cover how to create custom entities within Maltego using some more advanced options. Now, if you haven't watched the first video on making custom entities using the basic methods, I encourage you to check that out before watching this video, as it's going to set the foundation for what we're going to build upon. There are two ways to create more advanced entities. If we go over to the new entity type button and click on the down arrow, we can see that we have two options here, basic and advanced. The basic option is what we went over in the first video, so this time, let's click on Advanced. Now, some of these options, like the basic information and the main property sections, should be familiar, as those are the options that we use when we created the entity using the basic method. However, by clicking on the Advanced option here, we get a few more categories, such as additional properties, display settings, and advanced settings. If we want to create a new entity from scratch using the Advanced option, this is where we would do so. But what if you already have an existing entity you created using the basic method, like what we did in our first video, and you'd like to have more advanced options added to it? We can still add these options in by going to Manage Entities, locating our previously created entity, and then clicking on the three dots here on the right. Now, one thing you might notice is we only have four options here versus the five we had in the previous method. Using this method, we're unable to actually edit the main property value we set during the initial entity creation. So that's something you want to keep in mind when determining which of the two methods you want to use. The basic information we see here was created in our last video. We actually don't want to change any of those parameters at this time, so let's click on the Additional Properties tab. Now, this is where we're going to add additional properties to our entity, other than the ones we initially inherited from the Maltego Person entity. Let's click Add Property, and we're going to create a new property here that tells us what country issued the red notice. Enter in the name for the property, making sure that it doesn't have any spaces. For the display name, this is what you're going to see on the Maltego graph, and this one can actually have spaces within it. And finally, we need to choose what type of property this is going to be. As you can see from the drop-down here, we do have multiple types, but I'm going to stick with string. Now that we have our new property, we can tweak it a bit more by double-clicking it. We have three unchecked boxes here that we can check if we want this property to be required for all entities, if we want the property to be read-only, or if we want it to be hidden. Since none of that applies to us, we're just going to leave them unchecked as is. We can also add a description by clicking the three dots here on the right. Let's add in country which wants the person of interest. We also have the option for default and sample values. So when you drag the entity from the entity palette over into your graph, it will automatically add the sample value for you. So let's go ahead and add in here FR for France. I'm now going to add in two additional properties, one for the wanted person's date of birth, and one to hold the URL of a photo of our wanted person. I'll also add in a sample DOB for this property, but we're going to leave the photo URL one as is. Next up, let's take a look at the display settings. This is where we can customize what properties or values show up in the entity when it's on our graph. The edit value is the value you would be able to edit whenever you double-click the entity. If, for whatever reason, you wanted to change that to a different property, you can click the drop-down here and choose any of the other properties that we added. The display value is going to be the text that displays below your entity on the graph. This can also be changed to any of the other properties as well, but for our purpose, the full name makes the most sense, so I'm going to leave it be. The large image is going to be the image for the Interpol red notice, which we already uploaded in our previous video. If for any reason you wanted to change this, maybe to an image URL that exists in one of the property values, you can do so here. The next section allows us to add overlays to our entity, which pull from our various property values. They will display above, below, or to the side of our larger image. I'm going to take our photo URL property, and I want to overlay it above our red notice image. It might also be helpful to be able to view the wanted person's date of birth on our graph as well. So let's place that overlay here to the left. Don't forget to change the type from image to text, since we want the overlay to show us the text that corresponds to the date of birth, not an actual image. Finally, on the lower left, I want to overlay the wanted by property. I'm going to leave this type as image, because if you remember earlier in our video, we put the default value here as FR for France. Since we chose the type as image, what Maltego is going to do is it's going to recognize that the text we added, the FR, and it's going to display the image of the French flag for us whenever we drag the entity onto the graph. The last set of options we have up here on the top are the advanced settings. Here you can change how Maltego displays the plural version of your new entity. Typically, Maltego gets this correct by default, but it's never a bad idea to check. Palette item is checked by default, which just means that it's going to display the new entity in the palette over here on the left. If you want Maltego to automatically recognize your new entity whenever you paste in matching values into the graph, you can do that here in the text conversion section. This is not something that I used during my investigation, so we're just going to leave that as it is. But just to give you an idea of how the text conversion section works, we're just going to copy over an IP address here into our graph, and we can see that Maltego correctly assigned it to an IP address entity. The same thing happens if we paste in what it looks like a first and last name, which Maltego automatically creates a person entity using those copied values. Now, let's remove those and take a look at our newly completed red notice entity. You'll notice that when we drag it over here, we have the John Doe sample value for the full name, just like a person entity where we inherited that value from. We also see that it added in an icon for the French flag down here, as well as the sample date of birth that we initially added in. Something that we don't see, however, is any overlay related to an image URL, which should display above here. If we double-click our entity, we can take a closer look at the different property values. The three we inherited from the person entity are already shown here, but if we click more, it'll show the others that we just added in. You'll notice that they all have sample values in them with the exception of the photo URL. This is because we didn't add any sample value to this property when we set it up. Instead, it's only going to display something as an overlay if there is a URL to an image in the property value. We can now use our custom entity in our investigations. However, the real power of Maltego comes from being able to automatically create entities and assign them property values without having to do so manually every time. We're going to cover a few ways of doing so in upcoming videos.